This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I'm going to show how to calculate payments with the future value formula. I'm going to do this with a TI-83 or TI-84 calculator. Here's the problem we're working with. The problem says you want to start a college fund for a baby. You could deposit money at 5.5% compounded monthly, and you want to have $40,000 at the end of 18 years. How much money should you deposit each month? We're going to use the future value formula to do this. The future value formula says that the future value, that's the amount that we want to end up with, in this case the $40,000, is equal to the payment amount, that's what we're looking for, times 1 plus I, where I is the rate per period as a decimal, raised to the n power, and n is the total number of periods, minus 1 divided by I. So we're going to do this with a TI-83 calculator. Rather than do the whole problem all at once, I'm going to start out and figure out what this I in the numerator is. Then I'll add a 1 to that. Then I'll raise it to the n power. I'll then subtract 1, divide that answer by I, and I'll then have the future value equal to the payment times some number. I know the future value is 40,000, so I'm going to take the future value and divide it by this number I get here, the amount that I'm multiplying the payment by, and that will tell me what the payment is. Okay, so let's give that all a try. I want to start out by figuring out what I is. So I is the rate per period as a decimal. Well, the rate per year is 5.5%. So we'll turn that into a decimal. That's 0.055. And to find the rate per period, we'll divide that by 12. Now that I have the rate per period, I want to add a 1 to that because I want 1 plus I. I'll take the 1 plus I and raise it to the n power. So I'll use this raise to button, the one just below the clear button. And the power is going to be the total number of periods. Well, there's 12 periods in a year, and there's 18 years. So I'm going to use parentheses and just multiply 12 times 18. So the answer is now raised to the n power. I want to take that, the 1 plus I to the n, and subtract a 1 from it. So I'll take that, subtract a 1. I have 1.685, and I want to take that number and divide it by I. So I'll divide the answer by, I need parentheses for this, I is the interest rate per year, 0.055, divided by the number of periods per year, which is 12. I've got 367.67. So at this point, I know that the future value, $40,000, equals the payment times this 367.67. So if I divide the future value by this number, 367, I'll get the payment amount. The future value is 40,000. I want to divide that by the answer. So I'll use second and the answer button, which is right next to the enter button. And what I get is $108.79. What this means is if you wanted to end up with $40,000 after 18 years, and you could deposit money at 5.5% compounded monthly, you could get that amount, that $40,000, by depositing $108.79 into the account every month. Okay, so I hope that helps. Take care. I'll see you next time.